President Yoweri Museveni and his counterpart William Ruto, the President of the Republic of Kenya, met in Nairobi yesterday. The two leaders discussed key bilateral issues, which they say will help foster a relationship between the two neighboring countries. During the meeting, President Yoweri Museveni expressed optimism about this encounter, saying it brings the two neighboring countries closer to the three historical missions, that is, prosperity through wealth creation and market access, strategic security, and utilizing maximally the Undugu.
So I'm very happy about all these projects will now move us closer to the three historical missions: prosperity through wealth creation and market access, strategic security, and utilizing maximally the Undugu.
Among other issues discussed was a tripartite agreement regarding the importation and transportation of refined petroleum products, as well as regional security, among other bilateral issues.
The tripartite agreement on the importation and transit of refined petroleum products through Kenya to Uganda, whose signing we've just witnessed, enables Uganda National Oil Company Limited to import refined product commodities directly from producers in different jurisdictions, thus bringing to an end the challenges faced by the sector in Uganda.
A number of bilateral agreements and policies were signed at the State House in Nairobi during President Museveni's two-day state visit in Kenya. The police's crack unit, the Flying Squad, tasked to crack down on violent crime, has arrested Ashraf Kiza, the suspect behind a movie-like robbery captured in a viral social media video, the Kampala Metropolitan Police has announced. The assailant, armed with rudimentary tools including a machete and a hammer, violently attempted to rob a businessman, Sam Turiamhachi, at Bashir Grain Millers in Natete Kutano on evening of May 13th. In a distressing footage, Kiza is seen demanding money from Turiamhachi, whom he assaulted with his killer weapons. Turiamhachi, who sustained several body injuries, is grateful to the Crime Intelligence Police for quickly swinging into action and tracking down the assailant.
Nebaza ekitongole kya Crime Intelligence amanyi ge bakozesizza okulaba nga bakwata omutima era ntuusizza ku kino. N'essaawa za kaakati ndi mukuva mu ddwaliro. Sinaterera bulungi.
After eluding authorities for 2 days, Kiza was finally located in Chotera on May 15th, thanks to the diligent efforts of the Flying Squad unit, a crack unit attached to the Police Directorate of Crime Intelligence headed by Brigadier General Christopher Damlira. He is now detained at Natete Police Station pending further investigation after his transfer from Chotera District. According to Luko Wesigiri, the Deputy Police Relations Officer for Kampala Metropolitan, Kiza will face prosecution in accordance with the law. The Mbale City Roads Committee, headed by the Industrial City Division Member of Parliament, Honorable Karim Masava, convened a meeting with the key stakeholders to assess the progress of the roadworks in the city following the allocation of the funds by the government. Honorable Masava expressed concern that Uganda Road Fund had not been utilized as expected. He also demanded a detailed explanation from the city engineer regarding the expenditure of the funds.
Because when you look at like Osmi, that is about 12 billion shillings that has come. And it has done quite some work. But then the challenge concerns the URF, Uganda Road Fund. We received about 350 million shillings, and up to now, as a city roads committee, we have no accountability. And no, we do not have the details of how much so far has been spent.
Mbale City Engineer Edson Kasata reported that the funds were received and that work is currently ongoing on Kaguta Road and the three other roads. He clarified that Kaguta Road will not be tarmacked, as some had anticipated, but will be a Maram Road. Engineer Kasata also highlighted the significant challenges affecting the timely completion of the roadworks, but urged the public to remain calm as the rehabilitation works continue.
And the nature of work there is heavy grading. So let the community not expect tarmacking, because what I hear on the streets, they say, the presidential directive to tarmac Kaguta Road, it is not tarmacking. I want to make that clarification. It is heavy grading and drainage works.
The Mbale City Roads Committee chairperson forced the Ministry of Finance for the late release of the road funds to the local governments, as well as lack of construction machinery, which he says slows down the construction.
They failed to make any release in the third quarter. If they had released money, we could have worked on some of the roads still. but they have released this money in the last quarter, which is about 2 months to the end of.
Initially, government disbursed 1 billion shillings, followed by addition of 500 million and 350 million shillings respectively for the rehabilitation of Kaguta Road, a project mandated by the presidential directive, along with other roads such as Nankusi and Namakole Road.